Welcome back to Country Double Play. It's Emily and
Grandpa John.
And today we're going to be listening to Crazy by Patsy Cline and Willie Nelson.
And we'll just get right on into it. Here we go. Okay, today we're doing Crazy by Patsy Cline and Willie Nelson. With some help from a friend named Oliver English, Nelson wrote the song in early 1961. At the time, he was a journeyman singer-songwriter who had written several hits for other artists, but had not yet had a significant recording of his own. Nelson originally wrote the song for country singer Billy Walker, who turned it down for the same reason Roy Drusky turned down I Fall to Pieces the previous year, that it was a girl's song. The song's eventual success helped launch Nelson as a performer as well as a songwriter. Patsy Cline was already a country music superstar and looking for material to extend a string of hits. She picked it as a follow-up to her previous big hit, I Fall to Pieces. Crazy, its complex melody suiting Cline's vocal talent perfectly, was released in late 1961 and immediately became another huge hit for Cline and widened the crossover audience she had established with her prior hits. It spent 21 weeks on the charts, topping out at number 2 and eventually becoming one of her signature tunes. Cline's version is number 85 on Rolling Stone's list of the 500 greatest songs of all time. Okay, and since Willie wrote the song, I guess we'll let Willie go first.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Crazy. Crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long as you wanted. Somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew that you'd love me as long as you wanted. Somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
Okay, so now what I consider one of the greatest country classic songs sung by one of the greatest classic country singers, Miss Patsy Cline.
Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long as you wanted, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? What in the world did I do? Oh, crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying. And I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying. And I'm crazy for loving you.
Okay, so what'd you think? I don't think there's a contest, but
I think, wait, which one do you like?
Oh, Patsy Cline.
At first, it kind of, I don't know, when I was listening to her version, it almost was like they were two different songs. Like, I didn't even feel like they were the same song they were singing.
And I'll explain that in a minute.
And then
No, but you're right. That's exactly what it, that's exactly right.
And then I started to like her version better.
There you go. So here's the thing. So, Patsy Cline was in a serious car accident in June of 1961, and she was seriously injured. She it was a head-on collision, killed the other driver. She smashed into the windshield. She had a huge jagged scar across her forehead. The last picture you saw of her had a headband on. She started wearing those to cover the scar. She dislocated her hip and broke her wrist in the accident. She didn't get to follow up on the I Fall to Pieces, so because she was in the hospital. She stayed in the hospital for over a month. In August of that year, they brought her into the studio to record Crazy. She heard Willie's version of it, and she didn't like it. Willie sings behind the beat. She didn't like the style. She tried to copy it, and she couldn't do it. And in those days, the norm was to record four songs in about a three-hour session. She was in the studio, and because of cracked ribs and whatnot, she couldn't hit the high notes. So she was really disgusted. They'd been working on the song for over 4 hours. Finally told her to go home, come back Monday, and we'll try it again. This was one of the first times Patsy had never recorded a song on the first take. So she came back Monday. They said they'd have the instrumentals all ready. They'd pick out, you know, better instrumentals that they'd worked on all week. And she nailed it. They said first take. And, of course, the rest is history, and it's become one of the, you know, number one songs of all time. Anyway, and that's kind of why you saw the difference. And that's why it sounds like two different songs, because her producer told her, just sing it your way. Sing it the way you would sing it.
It's kind of like I almost forgot that the whole point was of us listening to one song by two different artists. Like, I felt like we were just sitting here listening to music because it didn't sound like the same song.
Right. And that's kind of the idea of this whole channel, is that you could have two people sing the same song and sing it entirely different. And again, it was a hit for Willie Nelson too, and helped get him started as an artist. That's kind of that in the history of that song. And again, like I said, I think that was one of the, you know, just probably one of the greatest songs ever written and recorded. So it's one of my favorites. It's probably in my top 10 of all time greats. Let me see. I was going to talk. Oh, here's what I was going to talk about real quick. So one of the things I do, my family volunteers a lot in town. And one of the things we do is we put on an event called the Simi Valley Days Parade and Carnival. And one of my jobs is I'm actually CEO of the foundation that puts on the event. And then my other two hats are I'm head of security, and I'm also the music director. So, or the music chairman. Thank you. Yeah. And Miss Emily here, our 18-year-old granddaughter, is in charge of the parade. It's pretty much a family event or family affair. But anyway, the point was is that as the music chairman, I booked probably, I think I have 15 bands for this event this year. And that's for 3 days. And usually if we do Thursday, we'll do three more. So, you know, I'll book up to 18 bands. I'll get these demo tapes. People will all want to play. Oh, we want to come to your event. We want to come to your event. And the demo they send me is a cell phone video, you know, from halfway back across the bar or something. Nobody wants to seem to plug into the soundboard. And then I'll listen to the songs, and they're just singing the song. They're just singing the song. You listen to Patsy Cline and a lot of these other guys, sing the song like it happened to you. You know, sing the song like you mean it. It makes a huge difference. I'll listen to these bands, and people go, oh, I love these guys. And they're just singing the words. They're just playing the music and singing the words, and there's no passion to it. If you ever want to make it in the music biz, you got to learn to sing, and not just the notes, and not just be able to carry a tune. You got to be able to sing the song like it's yours and make it yours. And that's what happened with this song. They told Patsy, forget how Willie sang it. Sing it like you would sing it. Sing it like you sang all your other songs. And that's what made it such a successful song. Pour your heart out, you know? And so if I could give any advice, and I'm not a musician or a singer by any means, I'm just telling you that, yeah, if you like to hear cats fighting. But anyway, my point being is this, so that I know what I like, and if that's what you're going to do with your life, do it right. Do it right. You know, there's no sense going out there and doing anything half-assed. That's just, you know, anything in the world, you should be doing it right. So
preach it.
Preach it. Give me a hallelujah. Okay. So we're a little behind this week because we had some things come up. And so we're either ahead or behind, depending on which way you look at it. We tried to get the videos out on Thursday. Today is Monday. And I think we're going to try to do another one on Thursday.
As long as no one is telling me this and that throughout this week.
Poor thing, she's had like three appointments and people have canceled on her. And so when she cancels, then we just say, okay, well, we'll wait. And then they don't show up, and we probably could have done it. But So we'll try to do another one on Thursday to get back on track. And again, hope you guys liked it. Hey, we're getting a lot of nice comments, a lot of stuff. We're probably, I don't know when, I'm going to start thinking about changing, not the format, but maybe the style. There's some, and part of this was her idea. You know, we don't necessarily need to go country. There's some rock songs that country artists have done. There's some country songs that rock artists have done. We'll switch it up a little bit. And,
like that one showed you.
Yeah. And, you know, we were talking about it, and she said the other day, there are some songs that you just should leave them the way they are. And we'll see what happens with some of those. So anyway, we have that coming. We hope you like the new format. Been working on it. That's why I'm iffy about Thursday. Like I said, it takes me a little while, and I have to have some quiet time to do this, to put those videos together.
Our lives are always just full of, we're always doing something.
Yeah. And, you know, grandbabies to babysit and stuff like that. So anyway, again, hope you liked it. Hope you enjoyed it. And, we'll see you real soon. Bye.
Bye.